Yeah, my name's Courtney Kardashian. I'm really excited to be on the show. My family and I think we're going to kick some booty tonight and over the coming weeks. Okay. So yeah, you know, hopefully Kim won't be too frustrating this time. But we'll see. We might have to teach her a lesson. But yeah, in any case, look for us on the winner's podium.
Hello, my name is Jennifer Lopez, and I'm your host here on Kardashians Versus. This week, we'll be taking the Kardashians out into the wilderness to face a highly trained team of Da Vinci Charter Academy students. Now, let's go meet our contestants.
This project is gonna be awesome. I'm extremely excited. We've already started our project task list. We've got a good start on our need to knows. We know what we know, we know what we need to know. We know what our next steps are going to be. We've been watching some PowerPoints on making societies, making some weapons, on fighting, some basic survival tactics. And I really think we have a really good chance of applying all our Da Vinci skills to crush the Kardashians.
Hi, I'm Kim Kardashian. And, well, I was just wondering, like, what a society was. Like, is that, can you buy, like, where would you go to buy a society? Oh, have you seen my new haircut? I kind of like it short, but I'm not really sure about it yet. I mean, I don't know.
So, yeah, some of the people in our group, they feel like we can beat the Kardashians. I feel that way too, but I feel like we need to not necessarily establish a social contract for our group, but we just need to let things work out the way they'll work out. And we'll, just with the basic respect, I think we'll be well off.
So I heard what they were saying about us in the People magazine, and I want those Da Vinci kids to know we're gonna beat them like a bad dog and they won't know what hit them.
We've already done our project scaffolding. We're working on how to apply our new knowledge of societies to actually creating one. I think we're really kind of going for an all-inclusive, very respectful society, peace-loving, so we can just relax and come together as one.
I think for our government, we should all be involved in it. I think it'd be great if we could all participate and make it equal, so that we all have an equal part in the society that we're creating.
I think that it's really important that we do our best to preserve people's creativity in our society. Because I think if someone's creativity is stifled, it's really hard for them to be fully human.
That seems like a good idea, but I think we need to make sure that the whole time we're doing this, we're having fun with it. Because if we're not having fun, we're not going to do well.
That's a great point. You know, guys, I think it's amazing that we can come together and talk about this, form some kind of idea, some kind of conception of what we want, you know, what's going to be good for our society. I think that's really cool.
Oh my god, Chloe, have you seen Kim's hair?
It's so stupid. Why would she get a haircut like that? She looks like a stupid 2-cent prostitute, you know?
No, I'm embarrassed that we're going to be on the show with her. She's going to be with that haircut.
That stupid haircut is going to lose us.
Yeah, I know.
Thing.
And she's our family.
You realize that? She's not my family.
We're like
that. No, not right now. Not with that haircut. Oh,
what is she doing anyways?
Does she think this is some sort of game? Because it's not. This is real life, alright? And she thinks that she can just lollygag around with her silly haircuts. This is not gonna fly.
I know.
The jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight.
So, guys, who's gonna be in charge?
I think I should be in charge.
No.
Why would you be in charge, you dumb whore?
Kim should definitely not be in charge. You. What? Where did you get that?
No.
Kim, you have a problem.
Put that away.
You have a problem. You have a problem. Kim, you have a problem.
Kim,
you have a spear-making problem, Kim. You need help.
Okay.
You can be in charge.
That's what I thought.
You have a problem.
I love having all this power. It's so fun just being able to tell everyone what to do all the time.
I really feel that Kim is developing a problem, and I don't know how to confront her because she's really, it's terrifying her with all those spears, and she is an addict and she needs help. Then that's the truth.
Guys, I'm worried that maybe someone will try to steal our bananas. Do you think maybe we should have some weapons to protect ourselves?
Connor, weapons are tools of violence. All decent men should detest them.
I think we need to find some food and shelter.
I think that if we all go looking for food and shelter together, then it will reveal itself on our path.
Guys, if we want to be great leaders, we need to stop trying to control. We need to let go of fixed plans and concepts, and the world will govern itself.
That's beautiful.
Guys, I feel this really great connection. I love you guys.
I love you guys.
I love you guys, love you guys too.
That we can actually beat them? But I was like, what if we killed them? Would they lose? I think so.
Oh my god, Chloe, that's brilliant! You're right, if we're the only group left, we'll win. But how do we kill Kim?
No.
Kim. Oh my god!
Kim, what have you done?
No, those aren't mine.
No,
I'm just holding them for a friend.
Kim, what did you do?
Okay. Chloe, we might as well make the best of it. Okay, so, we're armed now. There'll be no match for us, because if you're armed, you aren't despised. And I think the easiest way, we make them our friends. We'll deceive them, we'll lie to them, we'll think excuses, and then we'll cut their throats.
Okay.
Sounds like a good idea?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, go, sister!
Welcome to the island, guys. It's gonna be great competing against you.
Yeah.
Let's go, Kim, let's go!
I love moving from place to place.
Hello from the Kardashians!
So, I like that we're all alive right now. I wonder if maybe next time we could not get stabbed. I don't know.
I like that we handled our injuries well. I wonder if we could have less injuries.
That would be good.
I think that'd be a positive contribution to the team with her alive.
I agree. And I wonder, I feel like I can't really fulfill my life's purpose when I'm injured like this. I wonder if maybe in the future I could not get stabbed. Let's take some time, just contemplate what has happened and try and find our way. Let's meditate.